Hallelujah. He's on fire. And I saw in the right hand of him who sat on the throne a scroll written inside and on the back, having been sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong messenger proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the scroll and to loosen its seals?" And no one in the Shemayim, or on the earth or under the earth, was able to open the scroll or to look at it. And I wept much, because no one was found worthy to open and read the scroll or to look at it. And one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Yehuda, the root of David, overcame to open the scroll and to loosen its seven seals." And I looked and saw in the midst of the throne and of the four living creatures, and in the midst of the elders, a lamb standing as having been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven ruachot of Elohim, sent out into all the earth. And he came and took the scroll out of the right hand of him sitting on the throne. And when he took the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each holding a harp and golden bowls filled with incense, which are the prayers of the Kodeshim. And they sang a renewed song, saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slain and have redeemed us to Yahuwah by your blood out of every tribe and every tongue and every people and nation, and made us sovereigns and kohanim to our Elohim. And we shall reign upon the earth." And I looked, and I heard the voice of many messengers around the throne, and the living creatures, and the elders, and the number of them was myriads, and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb, having been slain, to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and respect and esteem and baraka." And every creature which is in the Shemayim and on the earth and under the earth, and such as are in the sea, and all that are in them, I heard saying to him sitting on the throne, and to the Lamb be the baraka and the respect and the esteem and the might forever and ever. And the four living creatures said, "Amen." And the 24 elders fell down and bowed before him who lives forever and ever. 6. And when I saw, and I saw, when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard one of the four living creatures say, like a sound of thunder. Come and see. And I looked and saw a white horse, and he who sat on it holding a bowl. And a crown was given to him, and he went out overcoming and to overcome. And when he opened the second seal, I heard the second living creature saying, "Come and see." And another horse, fiery red, went out, and it was given to the one who sat on it to take peace from the earth, and that they should slay one another. And a great sword was given to him. And when he opened the third seal, I heard a third living creature saying, "Come and see." And I looked and saw a black horse, and he who sat on it holding a pair of scales in his hand. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four living creatures saying, "A measure of wheat for a denarius, and a measure of barley for a denarius, and do not harm the oil and the wine." And when he opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the four living creatures saying, "Come and see." And I looked and saw a pale horse, and he who sat on it had the name Death. And the grave followed him, and authority was given to them over the fourth of the earth, to kill with sword, and with hunger, and with death, and by the beast of the earth. And when he opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar beings of those having been slain for the word of Yahuwah, and for the witness which they held. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, "How long, O Adonai, Kodesh and true, until you judge and avenge our blood on those who dwell on the earth?" And there was given to each one a white robe, and they were told that they should rest a little while longer, until both their fellow servants and their brothers, who would be killed as they were, reached completion. And I looked, when he opened the sixth seal, and saw a great earthquake came to be, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood, and the stars of the Shemayim fell on the earth, as a fig tree drops its untimely figs, being shaken by a strong wind. And the Shemayim departed like a scroll being rolled up, and every mountain and island was moved out of its place. And the sovereigns of the earth, and the great ones, and the rich ones, and the commanders, and the mighty, and every slave and every free one, hid themselves in the caves and in the rocks of the earth, of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, "Fall on us, and hide us from the face of him sitting on the throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb, because the great day of his wrath has come. and who is able to stand? 7. And after this I saw 4 messengers standing at the 4 corners of the earth, holding the 4 winds of the earth, that the winds should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. And I saw another messenger coming up from the rising of the sun, holding the seal of the living Elohim. And he cried with a loud voice to the 4 messengers to whom it was given to harm the earth and the sea, saying, "Do not harm the earth, nor the sea, nor the trees, until we have sealed the servants of our Elohim upon their foreheads." And I heard the number of those who were sealed, 144,000 sealed, out of all the tribes of the children of Uzziah. Of the tribe of Yehuda, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Reuben, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Gad, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Asher, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Naphtali, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Manasseh, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Simeon, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Levi, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Issachar, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Zebulun, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Joseph, 12,000 were sealed. Of the tribe of Benjamin, 12,000 were sealed. After this I looked, and a great crowd, which no one was able to count, out of all nations and tribes and peoples and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, dressed in white robes and palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, saying, "Deliverance belongs to our Elohim, who sits on a throne, and to the Lamb." And all the messengers stood around the throne, and the elders, and the 4 living creatures, and fell on their faces before the throne, and worshipped Elohim, saying, "Amen. The Barakah, and the esteem, and the wisdom, and the thanksgiving, and the respect, and the power, and the might to our Elohim, forever and ever. Amen." And one of the elders responded, saying to me, "Who are these dressed in white robes? And where did they come from?" And I said to him, "Master, you know." And he said to me, "These are those coming out of the great distress, having washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Because of this, they are before the throne of Elohim and serve Him day and night in His dwelling place. And He who sits on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. Neither shall the sun strike them, nor any heat, because